Hello, and thank you for watching. My name is Rachel Barnett with Gentle Frog. I'm here to create videos for you to help you understand QuickBooks slightly better than you currently do. If you have any comments, questions, or suggestions, please put them in the chat box. Thank you.
I want to show you how to add a note to the end of your financial reports, such as your profit and loss in QuickBooks. Before I get to that, I just thought I'd show you really quick what I did in ChatGPT to come up with my wording. I may change this in real life, but I was like, oh, maybe I can just show you a thing. So I went in ChatGPT and I said this up here. ChatGPT responds with this down here. This is an example of how you can use ChatGPT to help you come up with the right wording for things. Think of it like a friend who's always up for a good brainstorm. Let's go ahead and take this and let's copy and paste it over to QuickBooks. What I want to do is go to my profit and loss. I want to imagine that I have a scenario where I think the client's going to ask for audited financials. I'm a bookkeeper. I can't do that. And I know the client isn't going to hear that. So I want to go one step further and I want to put a disclaimer on the report. The reason you want to put a disclaimer doesn't matter. If you ever find that you want to put a note, a disclaimer, anything, I just want to show you how to do it. So we're going to go to the profit and loss report. Let's expand the date range since I don't have sample data for September. So I've got this report and I'm like, okay, well, I want to throw a note in here. Right above the business name, in this case, I love brainstorming, is this blue hyperlink that says add notes. I'm going to select that and I can just put the note down here. So now it's there. Let me just take a look and see what this looks like as a PDF. So when I look at the PDF, I can see it's right there as a note. So that's certainly a possibility. Maybe you want something different. Maybe you want it to be more direct. I can click on the pencil and then I can just append it. I wonder how much room we have here. Oh, we have tons of room. Right? So profit and loss. This report is a draft. So while I can put it as part of the header, I'm going to take it out of this and just leave my report title to be profit and loss. Maybe I do something smaller, like management use only. That doesn't seem so bad. You find whatever your groove is, and then there you have it. So you can print it, you can export it, you can do whatever you're going to do with it. I don't think QuickBooks is going to remember this and make it available the next time we generate the report. So let's just go somewhere else. We'll go to the expenses, and then we'll go to transactions, and we'll go back to reports, and we'll just take a look. Worst case scenario, we have to do it by hand or, you know, manually key it in each time. That's fine. It's not the sort of thing that comes up for me very often, but I just wanted you to know how you could do that in case it ever does come up, in case you ever want to make a note and have that note included on the PDF that you're sending to your clients. That's it. Hope it's helpful. Thanks.